Welcome to the last day of part 1 of this tutorial series. Part 2 will be entirely dedicated to opening and managing a window. So yes, it is a long and difficult process, and this is why this video will be a gentle introduction to Windows in Windows. So pay attention because the next tutorials will become easy only if you stay with me for this video, and I also have an interesting homework for you today. So the first thing you need to learn about is what is a HWND, and HWND stands for Handle to a Window. And it is just a pointer, so just a 64-bit number. A normal handle is also just a pointer, but they created a special type for a window handle, so it is easier for us to know when the API refers to a window or another type of handle. So in day 10, in main.cpp, I first call this function. All it does is to open a pop-up window that will be our victim. It will open it in another thread because the function waits for the window to be closed and we want to continue running our program while the window is running. As you will see in the next video, a window is not something that you launch and it exists. It is something that you continuously need to keep alive in your code. Now, some things that you should know about a window. We usually associate a window with a process, but a process can have multiple windows or no window at all. Any window has a position, including in a Z direction, that specifies what window is displayed on top of another. And they also have a lot of flags, like you can even make a window transparent and stuff, but we'll look at that in another video. Now I also want to mention that a window can have a children. A button, for example, is also a window that is child to a parent window. Now, when we'll be making games, we'll just have one window and make our own buttons. It is much easier than using the Windows API, but we'll still need one parent window. Okay, let's return to coding. Now we need to get a handle to our window, and the easiest way of doing this is to call findWindow. This will find the window by title and will return you a handle to the window. You can ignore the first parameter. Now, with your HWND, you can do all sorts of stuff to that window. The simplest function that we can call is showWindow. The first parameter is a handle to the window, and the second is the flag specifying how we want to show our window. And there are also some other strange flags besides show or hide. Okay. Next, we'll change the window's flags. To be more specific, they are called window styles, and there are so many that they have styles and extended styles. To get the current style, you call getWindowLongPTR, and it will return you a 64-bit number that is just a bit filled with the styles. I will use the XOR operator to swap the window styles border bit to essentially remove and add back the border to the window. Finally, we want to apply the style back to the window by calling setWindowLongPointer. As you can see, the window looks kinda strange without a border, so you shouldn't mess with this flag unless you know what you are doing. I am showing them to you for educational purposes. This is also how I made the notepad window in my Minecraft in Notepad video, refuse to get input from the user. There are many other flags like disabled, for example, as you can see here. There are also extended flags, but you have to use GLW, XStyle, here, and here to use those. GetWindowLongPTR actually can return you some other info about the window, but you'll use those in another video. Next, to get the window size, we call getWindowRect. This will give us the boundaries of the window's drawing area. So it will give you the beginning point of your window and the end point. So to get the window size, you just have to subtract those two points. Now let's move the window around. To move it around, we have to call setWindowPos. Now this function can move the window, resize it, and also reposition it in the Z order. So if you, for example, only want to move it, you have to pass these arguments to tell the function to ignore the resize and z-order parameters. We have to do something similar for resizing the window, and to reorder it on the z-order. Finally, we can even place it as a topmost window, meaning that it will stay on top on all of the windows. So let's take a look. We can get the window size, and after we resize it, we can see that we get the new size. We can move it around, and we can place it on top. Finally, if we set it as a topmost window, it will never be occluded by another window. Finally, this is your homework for today. You have to make this window run from the cursor, and you have all the knowledge that you need to finish it. I'll just tell you that you need to call getCursorPosition to get a mouse position. The homework solution is also in the repo, but try to solve it yourself. Now, share this video with a friend that likes programming like you, and subscribe because part 2 of this series is coming and don't want to miss it out. See you there!